Bora Borosa got its infamous reputation as a nearly impossible system to navigate because it was one large asteroid field. Planets had never formed, and so large chunks of rocks circled the sun in an endless dance of shifting gravity wells. To add to the chaos, treasure hunters and gangsters frequented the system in search of minerals and the rumored treasure of Bora Borosa. This was Brandin Dobah's reason for being in the system. He had some leads on its location, and had set up a base of operations within one of the larger asteroids. They had been there long enough now that the base had expanded into a true pirate cove with somewhat comfortable amenities. However, their time in Bora Borosa had also earned Brandin and his shipmates some enemies. He had chased competitors out of the system, but some of those had powerful allies who came back for revenge, such as Darkstar. They had sent a message to Brandin through one of their many street gang cells, warning him to back off from his treasure hunt and to never mess with any of their ships again. He hadn't listened, so they monitored secretly and waited for an opportunity. That opportunity came when his ship, the Sunset Gem, was damaged by an asteroid while on a routine investigation. His crew was in the process of repairs when long-range sensors on his base detected incoming Darkstar ships. They had to approach in sublight from a long ways away due to the difficult nature of navigating into the system via hyperspace. Nevertheless, they would be there soon, and the ship wasn't ready for it.
"Red alert," he called. "All hands on board the gem. Get weapons and defense systems repaired as quickly as you can."
Then another ship suddenly appeared on the scopes of the ship itself, whose range was not as long. This one was all alone, a YT-2400, not the kind of ship Darkstar used. How was this even possible? He ordered his ship to maneuver to the far side of the asteroid and run dark while continuing repairs. Rez avoided the asteroids with ease. Huff blasted any asteroids that came too close. R4 searched for signs of a ship or a base or wherever a pirate might hide. It found an energy source coming from one of the larger asteroids. A deflector shield surrounded the giant rock, which kept nearby asteroids from colliding with it. As a wall of asteroids cleared away, the asteroid came into view. It was clearly populated. Carved out holes revealed landing areas. Lights shone through a few windows. Discrete defensive and sensor equipment clung to the sides.
"Well, this is obviously it,"
Rez said.
"So are you going to ask him where your sister is?"
Inna nodded, never taking her eyes off the asteroid base. Rez pressed a couple buttons, then said,
"You're on."
"Captain Brandin Dobah, my name is Inna Zend. I've come to ask you a question." The pirate vessel appeared around the corner of the asteroid base.
"You have chosen an unusual time to visit, Inna Zend," came the response. "How do I know this isn't part of a trap?"
Inna thought about how to respond. She looked to Valina, whose eyes were half closed. She was reaching out, trying to sense the feelings ahead of them. She believed she must be reading it wrong, because she was sensing a high level of fear. But they would have nothing to fear from them. She told Inna off mic, and she was equally surprised. Then she said to the comm, "Because we want nothing from you, or from this system. I just want to find out what happened to my sister. You sold her as a slave." Brandin was silent for a spell. Then he said,
"I don't work in slave trade anymore."
"I know you don't, but this was from when you did. I need to find out where she was sold." They waited for a while. The Sunset Gem faced off across from Logan's run. Everyone's breath was still as they stood by. Huff began to speak on the communicator. "I have a bad..." "We already said that," Valina said.
"I don't know who you people are, but I've got a need for more guns," Brandin said. "So here's what we're going to do. I'm about to be under attack. You're going to help me fend them off. Then I will tell you whatever you want to know."
"It's just one person," Inna began. "I need you to..."
"Help me first, then I help you. Got it?"
Brandin demanded. "Okay," Inna agreed. "All right, ready your guns, guys," Rez said. "They're closing in at 3 o'clock high." Three Black Star Vipers bore down on them from the right side of Logan's run. The center one was painted blood red, leading the others from the front. Behind them was a YT-1300 with a similar crimson paint job along its cockpit. It signaled Logan's run, and Rez answered.
"Clear out of the way," the voice came. "We've come to destroy the pirate's nest, and we'll include anyone who interferes."
"Who dis?"
Rez asked.
"This is Priz Niweluso of Darkstar. These pirates are ours, and you will leave immediately or be destroyed."
"Please hold. Huff, they want us to clear out of here."
"Good. Let them think we are. I'm at the turret."
Rez swung the ship around the asteroid to his right. The Red Viper broke off to make sure they were leaving. The other two Vipers closed in on the Sunset Gem with their command vessel following behind. Satisfied that Logan's run was leaving, the Red Viper turned back towards its comrades.
But Rez continued his orbit around the asteroid and came out behind the ace fighter. Huff fired his turret and took down its shield, doing a little bit of damage to its hull. The fighter craft began weaving and dodging, making it hard to hit. The other two fighters were now closing in on the Sunset Gem. One of them was slowed by an asteroid, but the other got in on the pirate ship's rear. They fired a barrage, taking down its shields. Logan's run broke off the pursuit of the Red Viper and hurried to the Sunset Gem's protection. The Viper was continuing to fire into the pirate ship's hull as it swung around the corner. It came face to face with Logan's run, and the two fired at one another, exchanging damage. The Viper was able to dodge most of the shots, and it swung out of the way to the left. That was when the second Viper came around the corner. This one prepared for the YT-2400, and it already had it locked on. Huff continued to fire the ship he had damaged. Its incredible maneuverability was difficult to follow, but Huff put his faith in his new targeting array, and it predicted the movement successfully. He fired, pulling it away.
Don't damage my ship.
Valina fired at the ship in front of them, but was less successful as it blasted away the remainder of their shields. As if unconcerned now with Logan's run, the fighter turned on the pirate ship and fired. The shots rocked the ship, cracking its hull. It was ready to split like an egg. The ship fired back and only managed to take down the fighter's shields. Valina drew in a breath and reached out with the force. Her hands relaxed on the cannon, and she moved it lightly to the point that felt right. She fired, and the shot went out ahead of the Viper, which flew directly into it. It was a direct hit, and the Viper exploded. Logan's run now turned its attention on the other two. The Ace Viper was turning tail and leaving. The YT-1300 was breaking off. They had enough firepower to take on the pirate, but they had not expected Logan's run. And this was not a chance they wanted to take. Their advantage gone, the Ace Fighter took off into hyperspace. The YT-1300 signaled Logan's run. "You've made an enemy today," Prisne Weluso said over the comm. "We have your identification, Logan's run. We will remember you." And with that, the command vessel shot into hyperspace.
"Thank you for your help," Brandin Dobah said. "I owe you all a drink. Come land on our base, and let's talk."
Logan's run landed, and a headhunter fighter landed next to them. Out of it came an aqualish man who resembled the pictures in the wanted holograms. He strode with a confidence like a leader in a pirate would. Huff and Inna emerged from Logan's run first. "I'm Huff Fassett, captain of the Logan's run."
"That was some good piloting you did, captain," Brenda said.
"Well," Huff said, blushing. "Hey, I was piloting," Rez said. "Well, yeah, he piloted. I shot down the ships," Huff growled. "With some help." Brandin looked at them confused. "You sold my sister into slavery," Inna said.
"Ran the auction," Brandin corrected. "And I left the business soon after that. Went into something with a cleaner conscience."
"Piracy," Valina said.
"Cleaner conscience than a slave auctioner, yes. Now come on. A battle makes me thirsty. And you want answers about your sister."
The pirate cove was made out of tunnels carved through the asteroid that opened up into chambers they use as quarters, lounges, etc. All protected by a pressurized energy shield. Brandin showed them around, explaining how they got to building it. Their search for the treasure of Bora Borosa was uncovering some valuable minerals, enough to keep them flying. But it wasn't what they were there for. He knew they were close. And the time came when they knew they simply needed a place to lay anchor while they continued the search. Sometimes they set out from the system to raid a house convoy. Many of their members were former slaves they had liberated from those convoys. Maybe they could be used to free all the slaves? From the oppression of the Empire? Huff hinted.
"Oh, you're rebels," Brandin said. "We have a much loftier goal, to make ourselves rich."
Some pirates they were passing cheered at that.
"But we do owe you, my new friend. So, if you need us for something important, you call us, especially if there's wealth in it for us."
They came to the bar area, and Brandin gave them all various forms of whiskey. Inna's eyes had not left Brandin since they got there, so the pirate captain at last got down to business.
"So, your sister. Looking at you now, I kind of remember her. She was cute, part of the reason I left the business. But even still, I can't say I remember who bought her, let alone where she was taken off to."
Inna began to speak, but Brandin interrupted her by continuing,
"However, there is a way to find out who purchased her and where they went. The auction took place at the wheel orbiting Nilanen. Their computer databanks will hold the information you're seeking."
"How do we get into these computer databanks?" Inna asked.
"You'll have to figure that out,"
Brandin said.
"They'll be in their offices, so you'll have to sneak into them. You get into those, you'll know where all the slaves have been sold and can track down anyone you want."
Anna was a bit annoyed at having to land and take a tour of the Pirate Cove just for that information they could have received over the comms. But in looking at everyone enjoying their drinks on a much-needed break, she gave them some time before demanding they get going. If you enjoyed this video, please thumb us below and let your friends know. Also put in the comments anything you think the characters should have done differently. Click on the next video to continue watching the story, and you can find other stories written by the author in the description below. May the Force be with you, and happy gaming, everybody!